long is Principal Shepherd gonna keep us in detention down here?
Oh, you got a big date? Is that it? Gotta get out of here for a big date? Is that what you're saying?
Hey, bite my butt, Mom. At least I'm not a withered old slut like you are.
Oh, just kiss and get it over with.
Guys. It's natural that we'd be at each other's throats. All right, we've been down here for 3 minutes. The question is, how are we gonna get out?
All right, we're playing.
No, Meg! All right, who's next?
Hallelujah!
Peter, where are we going?
Relax, it's our nation's capital. I'm just a fan of history.
Peter, what are you up to?
What? I just love our government. Or at least I used to.
Hey, Cleveland, wake up.
Don't wake him. Don't wake him. I don't think he wants to be reminded.
You know, it's stores like this where you learn about the real history of rock and roll. Not the watered-down version you get in every movie about a musician's life.
Yeah, all those biopics are the same story. Unsupportive parents, hit song, band turmoil.
Having giant horse teeth and dying of AIDS, all of them are exactly the same. And check out this section for the Doors. Jim Morrison is a legend, whether we like it or not. He had the good sense to die before we could see him at the Pechanga Casino and go, oh my God, that's him?
Hey, Stewie, come on, let us out of here. Stewie?
Chris, now's our chance. We gotta get out of here.
Hidden somewhere?
Stewie! No!
My own brother. My so-called best friend.
I trusted you. I invited you into my man cave. And all you did was humiliate me.
Stewie, no, please don't kill me. Wait, did you make that?
What? Of course I did. Why?
Wow. No, it's just, I just don't know how you're able to make such cool weapons at your age.
Wow, that is really well made. Holy crap.
Do you have any others?
Yeah, of course I have more.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I have like 100. Wait a minute. You're not gonna win me over with flattery.
Is there anything else you like about it?
Yeah. I mean, check out how sturdy the sight bridge is.
First thing I noticed too, Chris. And of course, the cocking stirrup.
Yeah, very pretty. Barnett makes a hell of a bow, but this is probably one of the nicest ones I've ever seen. Anyway, Stewie, you can go ahead and kill us now.
Listen, if you guys want, I suppose I could show you how to make one.
You'd do that? Even after everything Chris said?
Of course I will. I love you guys.
We love you too, Stewie.
Listen, go clean yourselves up. I'm around. Just come by whenever and I'll show you.
Thank you, Stewie. Do you do parties here? Because this is like a good event space.
Eric is turning 50 next month and we still don't have the venue.
I think we do now.
I'll put together a menu. Any dietary restrictions I should know?
He says he's on a seafood diet. He sees food, then he eats it.
I gotta meet this guy. He sounds like a nut.
We now return to Alice and Janney in Hello, Sexy.
And to your left, you'll see a joke about Alice and Janney being very, very tall. She has an Oscar, and we have a great deal of respect for her.
Nice Thanksgiving. I don't know why I ever listened to that jerk.
What? Home is this way. We're both just walking home. Leave me alone. No way. We're a team, Brian, whether you like it or not. Just like almond butter and no sugar added fruit preserves.
Who's hungry?
We are!
Hey, kids, would you like a terrible healthy sandwich?
No.
Too bad, because your recently divorced mom has a crush on her trainer, and he eats like this, so now you have to, too. Almond butter and no sugar added fruit preserves, just like PB&J, but with more of your mom railing this guy.
I name myself Kaya.
Now here to sing the Heart Classic alone is Chris Griffin.
I hear the ticking of the clock. I'm lying here, the room's pitch dark. I wonder where you are tonight. No answer on the telephone.
Turn around.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Are you okay to swim like that?
Am I okay to swim? I'm not. I can only flap about like a motorized tub toy. Please help me, and hurry. I'm about to get hit by the old retired guy doing laps. Quick, he can't hear me because there's an investment commercial playing in his head.
What are your retirement goals? Swimming past a tiny-armed fat guy flailing in a public pool? T. Rowe Price, we've got you covered.
Look at that guy. He did everything right.
Guys, please. I'm the one with the late fees. Don't hurt my family. I'll do anything.
Well, I have this screenplay. It's an epic sci-fi, and it's mostly stage directions where—
Just kill us!
What the hell?
Amazon drones? You saved us!
Once again, a streaming service annihilates a blockbuster! Wabush!
How did you even know we were here?
Based on your recent purchases, viewing habits, and stored data, we determined that you were being chased through the wilderness by the last two Blockbuster employees on Earth.
Wow, scary. I owe you an apology, Amazon. You're a pretty amazing service after all.
Yes, I agree. Amazon workers should not unionize.
I didn't say that.
Well, they sure can't play dumb when they want to. Please stop spying on us, Alexa.
Okay, playing holiday music now.
And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Oh, hey, Stewie, perfect timing. Amber, come meet Stewie.
Pass.
Oh, he's so cute. I just gotta kidnap him, don't I? Would you like that? I stuff you in a duffel bag, zip it up. We're in Indiana before you know it.
Chummed.
Isn't she awesome? You wanna come inside, babe?
Nah, I'm just gonna park it here for a few hours and watch Fuller House on my stepson's cracked iPad.
I'm telling you, Stewie, this thing is all next-level sex. The rugs in her van are just filled with crushed Fruit Loops. So while we're doing it, I can lean over and lick the crumbs.
I'm familiar with the temptations of crushed Fruit Loops, thank you. Brian, you should know the Nextdoor app is on fire right now. Have you seen the van? What's with the van? Here's a photo of the van. I checked with the police, and we can't get rid of the van unless we witness criminal activity. And then just some nervous comments about the black Amazon driver, but you get the gist.
We now return to America's Next Top Model.
I just don't think you're being fair, Tyra. You don't know what it's like to grow up the way I grew up.
You know what? How dare you? You don't know me. You have no idea where I come from, where I've been, how long I've been there, what I had to do to get from where I was to where I am now!
Damn it all!
Sorry.
Hey, shut up!
Keep it down!
Look, there's nothing I can do, all right?
Get inside, pal.
Have you ever heard of a sitter?
Look, it's an endangered species. What am I supposed to...
I'll make you an endangered species.
Oh, good comeback, Patsy.
I'll kick your ass, that's what I'll do. Yeah.
Look, everybody just shut up. Shut up. He has stopped squawking. He's receded into my beard. We can all watch the movie. Shut up.
Eric, if you're in here, we're all going to Marty's after the movie.
Oh, I love you so much.
I love you too, honey.
What's wrong?
Oh,
that's it. You're history, pal. No bird Frenches my wife and gets away with it.
All right, fellas, I just finished up an EVP session. Let's see if we picked anything up.
What's EVP?
Electronic voice phenomenon. Oftentimes, the human ear can't pick up paranormal sounds, but electronic recording devices can.
That right?
Are you the spirit of the woman who was shot? Did you used to live in this house?
Is this whole thing just you beefing into the microphone?
Yeah.
Dad, they did this bit in the Lady Ghostbusters!
Did you hear something?
Is it for you?
So unfair. I look like Ron Weasley.
I'm now a real estate broker in Winnush.
Tatum? Tatum!
Could you be quiet? I'm trying to wipe myself with the thinnest toilet paper known to humankind.
Why does that require silence? Tatum?
Oh, hey, Lois. What's wrong?
Peter, you gotta help me. I lost Tatum. We went into the bathroom, but now she's gone.
Well, if this isn't an excuse to climb a giraffe's neck, I don't know what is. You see her?
No, but do you see those hippos doing it?
Giraffe?
Oh, thanks for letting us stay here, Daddy. We'll be out of your hair as soon as the house dries out.
You know, Carter, we don't mean to be a bother. Why don't we just stay at a hotel and you pay for the hotel and it should be the Legoland Hotel?
I'm not giving you money for almost drowning my daughter and grandchildren. Besides, I have to leave town for a couple days and I need someone I can trust to look after the place.
Where's Babs? Why can't she do it?
I don't know. The ransom note didn't say.
Daddy, I didn't know you were leaving town. Where are you going?
Just some funeral. I'll be back in a couple of days. I left food out for the butlers. Just change their litter boxes tomorrow if you think of it.
That day we talked and talked as an unrealistic amount of leaves fell around us. Hey, thanks for walking me around in this watered-down Woody Allen movie.
You're welcome, Peter. But what do you think? Can a man and a woman just be friends without the sex?
Yeah, sure. Men and women can just be friends. But, like, the fourth or fifth friend you call.
What do you say, Peter? Friends?
Friends with benefits?
Benefits? No.
I was gonna say benefiber. I've been getting wicked stopped up lately.
Ew.
Welcome to being friends with a guy, Meg Ryan.
Who out there wants to take it easy?
Not me. Do you read the papers? Look around you.
All right, well, you want to take it to the limit?
Not really. That would be a little foolhardy, wouldn't it?
Okay, this time I set up the cutaway by myself and it sent us here. Weird. It's like this is a whole cutaway land, and it takes a setup from both of us to get us in or out of cutaway land, but only one of us to move within cutaway land.
Lois, are you saying that it takes a setup from both of us to get in or out of cutaway land, but only one of us to move within cutaway land?
Exactly, Peter. It takes a setup from both of us to get in or out of cutaway land, but only one of us to move within cutaway land.
I want to be done with this part.
Who likes life in the fast lane?
Not anyone who wants to get there in one piece.
Peter, this may sound crazy, but this is our chance at the getaway we didn't have at the beach.
Hey, you're right. No kids, just you and me. And we could go anywhere. Like when we hid in Tom Brady's locker and watched him shower.
To ruin Christmas. Who left all these dirty dishes out? Okay, much better. I'm not even gonna think about the grocery situation. Okay, ruined Christmas. Here we go. Don't even care if they transferred the wet clothes from the washer to the dryer. Oh, you see? I know it.
With anyone. Glenn, that's very sweet, but you're talking about your best friend's wife.
I know, it's wrong. And Peter's a good friend. Not like Cleveland.
Hey, I got two of these phone books. Didn't know if you wanted one. Hey, how long have we known each other? Long time. And yet we've never discussed mother's maiden names, the names of old pets, high school mascots, favorite teachers. Heck, I don't even know the last four digits of your social.
Cleveland, do you need to borrow some money?
I do. They're gonna kill Dinah.
Really?
No, I just want to buy a man's fur coat.
Get out of here!
Hey, Peter. I had an extra phone book and I...
I'm not buying you that coat!
Okay, we're getting out of this place tonight. Everyone clear on the plan?
Yep. Meg and I switch faces like in the movie Face Off?
No.
Oh. Then we have an issue.
I told you we should ask Mom first.
Why would you think that? Ugh. Just you two follow my lead. You know, Vera, I've been so moved by my time here at camp. I wonder if I could perhaps say grace tonight.
Oh, that'd be lovely, Lois.
I'd like to begin with a moment of silence, a fully counted out Mississippi 60-second moment of silence. And the first one to open their eyes is Gay.
Psst, up here. My eyes are open too.
There was something in the air that night. The stars were bright, Fernando. They were shining there for you and me, for liberty, Fernando. Though we never thought that we could lose, there's no regret.
Oh, look, it's one of those early Maud episodes with a really long opening credits sequence.
Sister who really could. Madame Curie was a strong woman character, working all day in a science lab, yeah. Clara Martin was a famous nurse who was rapping with the soldiers and bandages too. Susan B. Anthony, always out doing stuff, marching around and holding up sides.
And then there's Maud.
Pocahontas.
What the hell?
Had it all going on. An Indian guide with lots of Indian pride. Indira Gandhi ran a whole big country. That isn't easy, even if you're a guy.
And then there's more.
Babe Zaharias was
a really
good athlete. Good at track and field and professional golf, too.
And then there's more.
Amelia Earhart flew a lot of airplanes, except for that one time when she didn't come back. Cleopatra lived
and then there's more.
The
come
desert,
on.
But still found a way to keep herself looking fine. And then there's more.
There we go. That was an ordeal.
Wow, Peter, this has been an amazing week. You and I own a restaurant. Can you believe it?
I know. I feel like I'm dreaming. Wait, maybe I am dreaming. That means I can do whatever I want without consequences.
What are you doing?
I just adopted 30 puppies. Who's a bugger bugger? Who's a bugger 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 bugger? Who's a bugger bugger bugger?
Okay, now who here knows Jumper?
This is a very serious accusation. Is it true, Alana?
I'm sorry, Lois. I just wanted your life so badly. I've never seen a man love his wife as much as Peter loves you.
God, you need to get out more.
And your beautiful children, and your dog. The baby I never liked.
Well, I was on to you, so...
That's not why.
And you were gonna marry her.
I'm sorry, Lois.
What do we want?
Fair wages!
When do we want it?
Originally now, but it's been delayed until 9:40 due to weather in Philly.
This is a mess. It's working about as well as that animal sobriety checkpoint.
Excuse me, sir. Is that a baggie of catnip on your seat?
I have a card for that.
What else you got in here? Open container of cat food? Feather on a string? Is that a dead mouse? Get him off me! Somebody get him off me!
Think catnip's a joke? Think again. Vote yes on increased animal sobriety checkpoints. Paid for by dogs.
Oh, I'm sorry, was that loud? Oh, sorry, everyone. We're being loud. Oh, this is Anton.
Stewie, let Mommy help you into your high chair.
Well, I am a little wobbly today. It's your fault, you know. Stop it! We're with my family! Easy! You're pinching my pits! God, it's like being picked up with lobster claws. We hate her, by the way. Oh, I see you got my text to bring Rupert to dinner. You're looking well. And this is Anton. He's in the touring company of Dear Evan Hansen. Why, aren't we all very modern?
He's just here because I got gum on him and he's stuck to my hand.
Okay, that's sickening.
Remember when that bear used to be yours, Chris? Oh, you used to take him with you every...
You shut your mouth, you hear me? Shut it!
Oh, someone's tired. Brian, you want to put the baby down?
Okay, yeah, he is a little fussy. I'll take him upstairs. Come on, Stewie. Brian, he's not in Evan Hansen. He's a male prostitute. Very cheap.
This place is paying Meg to do what?
Nothing. When you have a million followers, people just pay you to hang out.
Yo, yo, yo! Everything here is made with corn syrup! Just drink the corn syrup!
Oh my God, she collapsed! We gotta get her to the hospital!
Anybody need a ride to the hospital?
What?
Does anybody need a ride to the hospital? How is she?
What?
How's Meg?
I'm worried! Her pulse is very weak!
Her middle finger smells weird!
Come on, children. Grab the dinner mints off the check and let's go. Woof.
That was an historic season. Historic. Excuse me, I think my steak is overcooked.
This is Applebee's. It definitely was overcooked.
Applebee's. Drink your blue drink and shut up.
Oh my God, your baby is adorable.
So cute. Let me guess, 10 months?
Oh my God, my new look is working. I'm back into months.
Chris, what's all that lotion for?
Are you a scientist, Mom?
I'm a scientist.
It's for masturbating.
Hi, are you Courtney from Tinder?
You must be Glenn.
I got you these. A lovely bouquet for a lovely...
Yeah, take off your pants and sit on the coffee table.
Okay. That was great. And we could still make our reservation.
What? Why? We already had sex.
Wait, so I don't have to make small talk with you or spend any money?
Of course not. Here, wipe yourself off with this West Elm catalog.
My God, this app is amazing! Thank you, cell phone Jesus!
Huh? Oh, yeah, fine.
We can go where no one else can find. I'm super good body
Excuse me? Are you in line for the bathroom?
No.
Oh. Then move! Give me the key!
Tell. Now, here's a story about a bunch of animals who went on a cruise.
Noah, I want you to build an ark.
Right. What's an ark?
A large ship, 40 cubits by 80 cubits by 40 cubits.
Right. What's a cubit?
Wait a minute. Are you just doing Bill Cosby bits?
Yeah, why not? All of his stuff is up for grabs. What's he gonna do, sue us?
Are you ready for me, Meg? Are you ready to get up?
Huh?
I said it's time to get out.
What the hell? Lois?
Put the phone down, Kyle H. So then I start hearing people say there are different levels of peanut allergies, and I was like, levels? I mean, when I hear allergy, I think rash, not throat closed car crash. Okay, I'm so glad that we could talk about this and that you understand how we got to where we are.
So are you going to let me go?
Yes, I mean, once I figure out this whole kerfuffle.
Oh.
Why? Are you scared, Kyle H? This isn't scary. I'm a good person. Now, there are two ways we can go from here. You can give me your absolute trust, or I can get you hooked on heroin. Heroin's not bad. Not having heroin, that's what's bad.
You can trust me. It's just...
Just what?
I have a cat. Someone needs to feed him.
Now, a bad person would say, who cares here? But since I am a good person, I will take care of your cat. Now open your mouth. I'm gonna stuff my son's baseball sock in it.
All right, Peter, it's all queued up. Just push this button.
Okay, here we go.
No, Peter, not that one!
Audible.com presents Are You There, Vodka? It's me, Chelsea, as read by Chelsea Handler.
Peter, that's the wrong track. Yeah, pretty good stuff, huh?
Chapter 1, Stuff I Can Fit in My Lady Place. Up first, Eiffel Tower Lego Sculpture. Yep.
Peter, we gotta stop this.
Soup thermos. Yep.
It's locked.
Yeah, awesome, huh? Wait, how come everyone's leaving?
Brother Brand All-in-One Fax Scanner Color Copier with Phone Attachment. Yep.
I memorize Rotten Tomatoes movie descriptions.
You'll have one meeting, and then the rest of the time, you just party.
Party with Preston, but he doesn't drink. I wish you guys could come. Wait a minute. Why not? You guys should drive down with me.
All right.
Let's do it.
Cedar Rapids, rated R for drug use and mild sexual content.
I've never been to Atlantic City. Let's just watch this ad from their tourism department.
Welcome to Atlantic City, the inspiration for Bruce Springsteen's saddest song. Want to see brown ocean water stained with gasoline rainbows? Come on down to Atlantic City. Love to watch guys with no noses fight women with trach holes? You're in luck. And if you're wondering where Taylor Hicks has been, he's here in a small lounge with a low stage. Atlantic City. Come flick a lit cigarette at a dealer today.
Thank you all for coming tonight. On your way out, please take a complimentary au pair. And of course, au pair is French for with jugs.
Your husband is remarkable. I am hereby changing his designation from charming to a triumph.
Hear, hear. Before you, the one who'd done the best in our group was Joan. She was married to a functioning alcoholic.
All our husbands were Christmas suicides.
Well, what can I say? I'm a lucky woman.
By the way, Lois, when we get back to our room, you can choose the streaming service we watch tonight.
Even Crackle?
Even Crackle.
Oh, God, Peter. I think we're stuck here.
Yeah. I'm also bummed because I'm missing that Australian guy's marriage to his catamaran.
Didgeridoo, you take this boat to be your wife?
I didgeridoo. And now, if there are any spiders the size of dinner plates that object to this marriage, please speak now or forever hold your peace.
Go get 'em, mate.
I now pronounce you man and boat.
Peter, I'm really worried about Chris. The shock of seeing Arthur Valentine die seems to have really gotten to him. I've never seen him so depressed and catatonic.
Well, you know, in Awakenings, Robin Williams tossed a baseball to Robert De Niro, and he snapped out of it and caught it. Maybe we do that?
Chris, you doing okay? It's Mom and Dad.
We thought we'd... Awakenings!
Peter, I'm not sure that's...
Awakenings!
You're gonna hurt him if...
Awakenings!
Peter, knock it off. I never thought Chris would take things so hard. I think we went too far by killing Arthur Valentine. We have to bring him back to life.
What? Are you serious?
It's the only thing that'll snap him out of it.
Well, maybe, but what if I try it with a basketball? Awakenings! Oh, God, that broke his nose. He didn't even flinch. It's bad. Let's do your thing. Let's twirl some toilet paper up into his nose, and then we'll do your thing.
You're not alone in this, sweetie.
Lois is such a monster!
Fellas, did one of you poop at the bottom of the stairs?
We all did.
In the middle, and it slinkied down.
Did you happen to film that?
I should have filmed it. That was the beginning of Peter's Law. Because of the Monterey Five, from that day forward, Peter's Law stipulated that every Monterey residence is required to have at least one away-from-the-ocean-facing toilet. This is better. I'll be right back. Hello, dear.
I heard the doorbell. Who was it?
Delivery guy. We ordered dinner.
Oh, where did you order from?
That place you hate.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, maybe I'll just come downstairs and join you anyway. You know, it's been about a week, and I'm starting to feel better.
No. Trust me. You don't want to go downstairs. Brian is talking about the Electoral College.
Oh.
Yeah.
I'll just eat dinner up here.
Excusez-moi.
Hey!
Hi, I have your boner and butt pills from Gladiator.
That's supposed to be discreet.
Hey, Dad. Where's Mom?
Upstairs. The big upstairs. That's what we call heaven.
I get it. I tell TJ that my late husband Scott...
Mom's calling.
I told them every time a bell rings, that's their mom saying hello.
Help,
saying help. She died very painfully. Pardonnez-moi.
You forgot your box of boner and butt pills.
It's discreet!
I have to wear it or my teeth will shift.
That's smart. Mine have shifted. See?
Yes! That's what I'm talking about, Meg!
Woo! I love hanging out with you. That was such a rush! This must be what it's like to get a B12 shot.
Hi, I'm a bored white person looking to waste $60.
Well, I have a certificate from a probably like 3-day course that says I can inject people with stuff.
That needle's clean, right?
You bet it is.
What are you working on?
I'm trying to write a nice letter to my wife, Marjorie, but I never been any good with... Damn it, what are those things?
Words?
Yeah, I never been any good at words.
In fact, I'm downright great at them.
I could help you if you want.
Yeah? Could you make it sound so she thinks me, a white guy, is the one who actually wrote it?
Easy. Write this. Dearest Marjorie, I can't wait to get home and back that big fat ass up. Back it up. Back it up. Wu-Tang Clan ain't nothing to mess with.
Dearest Marjorie, a lady who worked at the hotel we were staying at had, like, the freckliest chest I've ever seen. Yours, Vinny.
Ultimately, Vinny went his own way with the letter.
You okay?
Yeah, babe.
I gotta pee, but I don't want to move. I'm so comfortable right now.
I can pause it.
Well, I guess you could pause it. But you can't pause me!
Oh, I can't breathe!
Oh, this is torture for me,
too! Stop! Sorry.
Oh, that's all right. It's just your body. Sometimes things slip out. Probably just making room for something.
Like what?
Hey, gang, got room for one more right in the middle of you two? Come on, scooch apart there. Oh, what's this? Quagmire's cell phone. Well, now that you're with Meg, you don't need to be talking to Backbush anymore. Oh, and I'll send a text to Possible Nipple Ring saying you're off the market. Your Possible Nipple Ring? All right, well, I better send a text to Backbush. Oh, come on, I'm Backbush?
This can't be a surprise to you, Peter.
Yeah, I knew. I just didn't know you knew.
Thanks for doing this, Brian. And remember, just act like a normal, well-behaved, non-talking dog.
Non-talking?
Yeah, just bark and stuff.
Bark? Jeez, it's been a while. Let me give it a try. Brack.
Brack? What the hell is that?
I'm finding it.
Damn it, Brian, I knew you were going to screw this up for me. I thought you wanted to help.
Help? I'm not doing this because I want to help. I'm only doing this so I can have a front row seat when you crash and burn.
Okay, first of all, it's incredibly insensitive to say crash and burn to a pilot. And second, how dare you? How dare you, Brian the dog?
You know I'm right. You're gonna get tired of the sex, and then you'll move on to the next one.
Oh, because you know everything, right? Well, you're wrong, Brian. Okay, shut up. Here she comes.
Doggy. Big doggy.
That's right. The big doggy.
Good evening, folks. Would you like to hear tonight's specials?
That was loud.
So, what's everyone gonna get?
Hey, Chris, watch. I bet she orders the eggplant parmesan like it's something fancy.
I'm thinking the eggplant parmesan. It'll be like we're in Italy.
Our family should wear uniforms with basic bitches across the front.
What's wrong with eggplant parmesan?
Nothing. I was just making a joke. Stewie and I do it all the time.
Stewie is a baby. You badmouth our family to the baby?
Forget it. Forget I said anything.
Mom, Dad, Brian's talking crap about you guys to Stewie.
What? No, I wasn't.
Yeah, he was. He said we're a bunch of basic bitches. It's kind of true, yo.
Brian, if I was such a basic bitch, would I be wearing solid black umpire's shoes? Umpires are cool. They make the rules.
You got this down, water out.
Are umpires not cool? I'm starting to feel foolish.
Where the hell is my white wine with Sprite in it?
Hi again. That man over there reading a book by himself has offered to pay for your meal if you move to a table outside.
You're not the dick in this situation. You're paying for their meal, so you can't be the dick.
Okay, time to hit the road for the Sports and Memorabilia Convention. Ready to go?
Yep.
All right, here we go.
I have to go to the bathroom.
Chris, we just left.
I know, but I gotta go.
Fine, we'll pull over at Joe's.
Bathroom's for customers only.
All right, how much is the gum?
$4.
For gum?
Go somewhere else.
Fine.
Bathroom code is 66482610355 49.
Could you say that again?
You gotta buy another pack of gum. 66482610355 49.
Okay, 66482. What's the rest?
Here, let me have Tommy Two Tone sing it for you.
66482610355 49.
66482610355 49. I got it.
He got it.
I got it.
Boy, the clam sure looks different.
Yeah, just be careful with your collars on the way in. They're kind of sharp. Yeah, we'll have a round of beers for the table. Yep, we got her too.
It's good to have...
All right, Tom, if you want to be young these days, you got to do a wicked awesome GoPro skate video.
Scares, Latvia's number one bear prank show, now available in Region 3 DVD.
Hi.
Uh-oh. You own a gray Honda Accord?
No.
Okay, good. Good.
My name's Becky, and this is my son, TJ. You're the single dad, whose wife is...
2 feet under, yes. The shallow graves were cheaper.
I was wondering if you wanted our kids to have a play date. I know how hard it can be being a single parent. I can make some lunch, fire up the bounce house.
We'll do it. We'll do it.
What a beautiful day to not get bodily fluids thrown in your face and hair. And now for some rock tunes to pump me up. All right, because it's the early 90s. Vaulting over a log, jumping a water hazard, climbing up a cargo net. Becoming an FBI agent is basically like being on Battle of the Network Stars.
Wait a second. Mayor West didn't have any kids, but he did have a cousin, Wild West. You guys don't know Wild West?
No, and please don't diminish us for not knowing the same things you know. You know how to land an airplane? No, you don't, asswipe.
I'm sorry, I see you, Quagmire, I do.
Thank you.
Wild West is a legendary cowboy and a spokesman for everything manly. Look!
You work hard, and at the end of the day, you're more than tired. You're man-tired. And when it's finally time to kick off your boots and relax, nothing satisfies more than beef cigarettes.
Give yourself a treat, nicotine and meat.
Beef cigarettes, now with less hooves and snouts.
Look, you're not going to understand beer with numbers or PowerPoints. Beer is good because it makes you feel better and do awesome things you wouldn't normally do. Beer makes memories that will last until you black out. And when you forget, there are no regrets. Beer is courage. The courage to moon people from a not-moving car. Beer helps you achieve new heights, atop the shoulders of unwilling strangers in a chicken fight. Beer makes you grab the brass ring or the taser of a casino security guard. But if you won't listen to me, listen to Supreme Court Justice Brett Kavanaugh.
I liked beer, still like beer.
Beer is great because life is hard. Don't make it harder with seltzer. Oh my God, you're cheering me.
No, we just saw a picture of Bon Jovi on the wall behind you. But you still won us over. Pawtucket Patriot Ale will stay the choice of New Jersey alcoholics.
I hope everyone enjoys tonight's dinner. It was Meg's favorite.
There, Lois. Stop your crying. Stop it. Please stop. Stop. Stop it. Stop crying. Stop crying. Stop crying. Stop.
Before we eat, would anyone like to say something about Meg?
Okay, I feel all of you looking at me, so here goes. Meg, wherever you are, I hope that you're with Bubba. And I want you to know that Lieutenant Dan is walking around.
Is this from Forrest Gump?
I miss you, Meg.
Stop it, Brian. Stop your crying. Stop it.
Please stop. Stop. Stop it. Stop crying. Stop crying. Stop crying. Stop.
Stewie, is there anything you'd like to say?
Yeah. We're gonna save a lot of money on toilet paper. Ever see her wipe? She'd wrap up both hands like oven mitts and act like she was cleaning out a pot of burnt chili. Anyway, that's all I care to say about Meg.
Maybe we should just have a moment of silence as we hear the guy down the street scream at his barking dog.
Damn it, Rufus! Shut up! Will you shut up? Get in the house! Get in the house!
I tell you, Lois, being a masseuse is a tough job. But it all just goes to show that basically every licensed massage therapist in this country is a prostitute.
Oh, yeah, you can pretty much do whatever you want with any masseuse ever because they're all prostitutes.
And it's not just the masseuses. If you're ever seeing, like, a physical therapist or doing yoga with a private instructor, just go for it. There's, like, an 80% chance you'll get there.
But, Peter, there's one thing I still don't get. Why did you take the massage job in the first place?
For you, Lois. I did it to earn enough money to buy a comb for your beautiful hair.
Oh, Peter, didn't you know? I sold my beautiful hair to buy you a bottle of massage oil.
Great. So now I'm an unemployed masseuse with a bald wife. Merry Christmas. Lois, what are you doing here? Did someone die? Do I get to go home early?
Well, Peter, since you were having that jeans fun, I thought it might be fun to come by and sell some of my homemade jewelry to your coworkers during lunch.
What? Lois, you can't do that. Once a guy's wife sells something in the break room, no one ever looks at him the same. 2 years ago, Bentley's wife made him hang a sign-up sheet to sponsor her in an AIDS walk, and we've hated him ever since. Don't look at me, Bentley.
Well, Peter, all you have to do is say you like my haircut and I'll leave.
Never.
Suit yourself. Everyone, I'm Peter Griffin's wife. I took a jewelry making class last month with a group of preschool moms, and now I'm gonna do it as a career.
Hey, you want a half of my sandwich?
Oh, yeah, very cool, Bentley. Who made this?
My wife.
Oh, your wife with AIDS?
She doesn't have AIDS. She did a walk for people with AIDS.
But presumably there were people who had AIDS at the walk?
Yeah, but you can't get...
Yeah, it's a no on the sandwich, Bentley.
Brian, are you ready for my grand creation?
Serve it up, bitch.
Well, that was uncalled for, but get ready to be wowed.
What the? This is mud.
Yes, it's a mud pie. I use Legos for the fruit.
Stewie, you can't submit this. It's inedible.
Okay, now I know you're full of crap because everyone else loves it.
So delicious, Stewie. Best pie ever.
Wow, tastes great, Stewie.
So good. Boy, oh boy, oh boy.
Not so hammy, Meg. He's not an idiot.
Stewie, can't you see they're faking it to make you feel good?
What are you talking about?
So good!
We must insist on absolute quiet.
My God, you're right. They're all just lying to protect my feelings. This pie is garbage! And the contest is next week! I have to drop out!
No, you don't. You just gotta do the work. Stewie, you're a smart kid. I know you can bake a pie. And I'll help you.
You will? Thank you, Brian. This calls for champagne. Pop. Glug, glug, glug. Bottoms up.
Go with it. Ugh, Corbel.
It's not Corbel, it's...
Go with it.
Yes, I had some left over from Denise's wedding.
Who's Denise?
Go with it.
Fine. How is Denise? Did she have the abortion?
Abortion?
Go with it.
No, her alarm didn't go off, so she missed it. So, Brian, is this your first orgy?
Not going with it.
Oh, Peter, this game night was a great idea.
Yeah, this will be a lot more fun than last Saturday when we went to see the vagina monologues.
So, in international news, no luck yet finding Osama bin Laden, so the government is trying a new tactic. They've hired Jeff Galooly. Galooly. Sorry, I guess that joke was not so fresh. But you know...
Since he was a black performer, naturally he went on tour in the part of the country that's so racist, it's known as the Boston of the South. He was given a white driver. The record company chose an Italian-American man, so Muddy would be used to hearing all the worst racial slurs before he got there. Big Crawdad's guy, huh?
Oh, yeah, they're the best.
Please look at the road while you're driving. I wouldn't know about Crawdads. Never had them.
What? Oh, you gotta try them. Here, take the rest of mine. I insist.
But Muddy had had Crawdads many times. That was just his little trick for getting free Crawdads from Course Italian.
Peter, just let me speak to the voters about the issues they're concerned about.
Or, instead of doing that stupid thing, we could sabotage Wild West campaign. Come on, you can drive. Big Garfield fan, huh? Me too. Not this big.
Yeah, a lot of people think I'm obsessed, but I think I'm pretty normal.
Okay, you reeled me back in. Can't believe Doug's dad texted me and said we had to come to Doug's T-ball game or he was going to sue us.
Looks like they got Big League Chew.
Yeah, I saw that. I saw they got Big League Chew.
Ah, the baseball field. Good memories. Lost my V-card here with Jennifer Jason Lee in that dugout right over there.
That was fast times.
Yeah, fast for her, maybe. I took a while.
Excuse me. What happened to your big trip to Providence?
Peter, pick a better show. I was barely in that.
What HBO show do you want to do?
Easy. Big Little Lies.
Isn't that a show about five women?
Oh, I suppose it would be better if it were about five men.
Now that's interesting.
Boy, I have a whole new respect for Hayden Panettiere. Giggity.
I'm pulling up. You ready?
Oh, hey, Peter, listen, I can't work tonight. I'm spent. That last trick was like trying to use an empty bottle of hand soap.
But you gotta work. I set up five appointments. That's a lot of money.
Sorry, I can't do it. You're just gonna have to cancel them.
What the hell did you say to me?
Peter, what are you doing?
You tripping, boy? You're going out if I tell you you're going out, bitch.
Okay. But what's in your pimp cup?
It's actually a wheatgrass ginger mixture. I was in the middle of a cleanse. I didn't know we'd be doing this pimp thing, but I made a promise to my body.
Ah, not great.
Peter, what you doing all dressed up for church? This ain't Easter.
No, Cleveland, these are my work clothes.
You hosting Family Feud?
No, I'm a pimp.
Big Pete, if we're gonna be sitting, may I use my penis donut?
Bitch, I don't care.
Dang, Quagmire, you're lucky. He take care of you.
Yeah, no, it's great. I'm making a lot of money. I'm actually really happy. I'm actually very hungry.
Nobody's gonna want you if you're fat. You wanna eat? Get up to that bar and earn your keep.
Well, what should I ask for, 500?
You're not worth that much. You're trash. Ask for two.
You know I hit you and whore you out because I love you, right?
Hi there. You want a party? And can I have some of your bread?
How handsome, you can't have my bread, but you can have something of mine that smells like bread.
Okay, let's go.
Just so you know, it takes me a long time.
Good evening. Welcome to Big Pete's House of Munch. May I help you?
Yes. Do you accept the Discover card?
Ha! Hey, Lois, Diamond Jim Brady over here just asked if we accept the Discover card.
Oh, they're in an exclusive club called Anybody.
Yeah. No. I don't think so. You know, I would rather take two live chickens than your fly-by-night credit card. I would rather take a jar of pennies that's value was less than that of your bill.
Look, you don't have to insult me.
No. You are going to sit there and listen to the funny things I would take instead of your credit card.
The guy at table 7 complained there's not enough juice on his prime rib.
Did he now? Let me take care of that for him. Tell him bon appetit, douchebag.
Hey, Chris, what do you got there?
I made a birdhouse at school today.
Oh, looks an awful lot like the governor's mansion from Benson.
It is. I'm fond of the series, and I wanted the local birds to be aware of that.
Well, I'll be on the lookout for great tits.
Peter!
Well, actually, Lois, that's a species of bird that's known to frequent domestic birdhouses.
It's why I've always wanted a birdhouse. Hey, Lois, let's go outside and see if we can find some great tits. Because there certainly ain't any in here.
Remember those two we saw last night? One was bigger than the other.
Yeah, and the bigger one had a hair sticking out of that pointy thing. What do you call that pointy thing again?
The beak.
Okay.
Come on, Dad! Maybe we can get the birds to act out the Benson where a scheduling snafu forces the governor to decide between meeting the president or going to Katie's school play!
Scatterbrain, Governor. Well, there she is. A birdhouse. I just hope whoever moves in doesn't mind the Persian birds next door.
Hey, tweet, tweet! Check out my expensive fountain!
Dad, look!
You built a great birdhouse, son. I'm real proud of you.
Thanks, Dad. No! What just happened? What was that thing?
I don't know. Some kind of super bird. Or maybe an average bird who bought a Bowflex.
Well, that super bird ruined everything!
Indeed, a force to be reckoned with. Like Secretary of Energy Stephen Chu. Secretary Chu, Ways and Means has sent over a preliminary budget. It looks like the Department of Energy is looking at a 4% budget cut. Okay, no budget cut.
No budget cut.
Gretchen? Wow, you look great.
Yeah, I didn't have kids.
Oh, yeah, of course. But what the hell are you doing here? I haven't seen you in 20 years.
Peter, I finally got your letter. You know, the one where you said that you were having doubts about marrying Lois and you still had thoughts about marrying me.
Gretchen, I wrote that a long time ago.
Well, my answer is yes, Peter. Yes, I will marry you.
Gretchen, I am already happily, moderately relative. I am married.
Oh, then I suppose your wife is entitled to know that you were still in love with me just days before your wedding.
Blackmail! Thank you, Cleveland. And I don't know what to call the thing you're doing to me, lady.
Hello?
Hey, Lois, I'm at the small bodega in the living room lobby trying to pick out a new baby card for Janine.
Who's Janine?
Yeah, right. Anyway, should I get one with a baby with SpaghettiOs on his head, like, this is what it's gonna be like, or one with a stork with an injured back?
Peter, I don't care.
Well, time to live out my dream of becoming a bodega cat. I'm between the breads. Murder the carpet! What are you doing?
Can you help me down the stairs?
The doctor said to stay in bed a week.
You know, I just need to get out of this room, and my back is killing me.
Lois, if you stay up here for the rest of the night, I will use the marital tongue on you.
Okay, but this time I get to pick the spot. In the meantime, can you just get me the heating pad for my back? It's in the attic.
The roast! Wait a minute, I'm not cooking dinner. Heating pad, heating pad, heating pad. Aw, crap. Hey, what are you doing, Barney?
I told Lois I would bring her a loaf of my sourdough bread.
Yeah, she doesn't want it.
What? I just talked to her.
She's dead. Lois died. Go away.
Oh, my God. What are you doing with her washing machine?
It's not for sale. You'd need a furniture dolly to get it out of the basement anyway.
We have one. I'll give you $100.
Yeah, all right, okay, maybe. Will it fit through the bulkhead door?
Yeah, it looks like it'll fit. It'll totally fit.
Yeah, all right, let's do it. $100. It was bad enough with Mr. Lloyd thinking Cleveland's better than me. Now it's all our friends, too.
Oh, stop feeling sorry for yourself. You think I'm thrilled my husband got demoted? Bonnie's already rented one of those cars with a loudspeaker on top. She's telling everyone.
People of Spooner Street, Lois's husband got demoted. They're poorer now. Repeat, Lois's family is now poorer.
Use this as motivation. Think of how good it'll feel to prove your friends and Mr. Lloyd wrong. Now I'm going to take an incredibly quick lady dump.
Prove I'm wrong, huh?
Done.
That's exactly what I'll do. I bet they won't think Cleveland's so great when I get him fired.
Hey, Dad, how's it going? Have fun at the Browns?
I couldn't steal a ketchup. There were eyes on me all night.
Son of a bitch!
There he is.
He didn't get the ketchup.
Damn it!
Hey, these chicken nuggies are bone dry. What did he say about the ketchup?
This is the shirt you chose. Denim with all the Warner Brothers characters peeking out of the pocket?
Yeah, it's the fanciest shirt I have. But Warner Brothers wouldn't license their actual characters.
How are you, Doctor?
Oh, my God. Will you look at this? Bonnie's latest post has 43 likes. That's tied for the record.
Well, that's good, but it should say pretty good view from here.
No. It's because she's at the pier.
So, I love that.
Damn it, Peter, now she's got the Spooner Street record.
Hang on, I'm texting Quagmire in Cleveland. They gotta see this.
Oh, it's so nice getting out of the house. If I had to change one more diaper, I was gonna lose it.
I'm in exactly the same boat. I mean, what would our husbands do if they had to change their own diapers?
Different boat, Bonnie. Much different boat. Hey, I got an idea. Let's crank call them. Me first.
You're weak, Cleveland. You're worthless and weak.
You found Brown.
Hello, Cleveland. This is Michelle Obama.
It is?
Yes. I received all your letters, and I do like your mustache.
Oh, I've been doing all your arm exercises.
Thank you, but those won't work on your fat arms.
How do you know my arms are fat? I deliberately left them out of all the photos.
You're eating a pie on the toilet, aren't you, Cleveland?
Who is this? Is this a jerky boy?
It's your wife, you big dummy.
I used to have my own show.
Hello.
Hello, is this Joe Swanson?
Wait, you can talk normal?
What do you mean?
Never mind.
We're calling from WQHG, Quahog's Hottest Hits, and we'll give you $500 if you can sing Britney Spears' I'm Not a Girl, Not Yet a Woman. You've got 10 seconds to...
I'm not a girl, not yet a woman. All I need is time.
Oh, but you have to be able to walk.
Ah, nuts.
Okay, my turn.
Hello, don't say anything about the 1998 Oscars. I'm watching it now.
Hello, is this Peter Griffin?
If this is the fracking people, I have made it clear that I am 100% on board.
No, my name is Rebecca. You've never met me before and probably don't even know I exist, but you're my father. Hello?
How'd you get this number? Don't you ever call here again.
What the hell? He just got mad and hung up.
He what? Why?
I don't know. He sounded weird. Like when he was an NFL announcer and had to pretend he cared about the shows after the game.
Patriots calling their third and final timeout. Hey, after the game, keep it here for an all-new Madam Secretary. Tonight, Madam Secretary faces an international crisis in Pakistan while her teenage daughter faces her own crisis finding a date for the prom. Madam Secretary, tonight on CBS. Is this the longest timeout of all time? Public library. I'm just gonna put my backpack down for 1 second, and it's gone. My laptop was in there, no password, my wallet, everything. That person is now me. My entire life went away. Hey, how do you find something in here?
Wait, it's a lot easier than finding a man out there.
Yeah, maybe wash your hair, lose the bun, give that a chance. Anyway, you guys have 1984.
We've got it on CD. CD. Sounds like my high school report card.
Okay. All right. Okay, boring book, 1984. I am ready for you to be lame and a book and not something unexpected. This is books? Books kick ass!
Probably reading Orwell.
But you don't?
No, I don't play those games.
Hey, I'll be right back. I'm gonna grab another napkin.
Boy, that guy Chris kind of sucks, huh? I want you and Jacksonville to come to Stewie's birthday party at my all-glass house this weekend.
Well, thank you, Peter. That sounds so civil.
Back to the BK thing. A Whopper Jr. isn't, like, younger than a Whopper, right? It's just a name?
Yeah, it's just a smaller version.
Yeah, that's what Wikipedia said. I don't know...
Hey, Stewie, we really crushed it last night in that escape room, huh?
Ugh, don't say crushed like you're trying to sell me a Range Rover. I did well, Brian. You just copied my answer and took credit.
Whatever, Stewie. I don't know why I always need your validation. I should just let you enjoy your superior intellect while you still have it.
What does that mean?
Oh, did you think you were the only smart baby in this family? Chris and Meg were just as smart as you were. But once a Griffin hits puberty, they turn into a full-blown bozo.
Bozo the Clown?
Yes, of course, Bozo the Clown. What other bozos are there?
I don't know, Bozo the Tax Accountant?
Well, the good news is, since you do a sex advice podcast, which I really like, by the way, every time you... it's a write-off.
Really?
Oh, yeah. And not just... also... and even...
Are you kidding me?
Do I look like I'm kidding?
And then she kissed me. I don't know what to do. I guess lying about having a dead wife to eat popcorn wasn't the best idea.
That's a nice story, Peter. Did anyone else break any sacraments this week?
Well, there's two things you can do from here. Break it off or go full scumbag. If you're interested in going scumbag, I sell a starter kit. It includes a second phone, fake addresses, and some golf shirts.
I don't golf.
Nobody does. Golf was invented purely so husbands can cheat on their wives. A six-hour game in a completely different town where you need special shirts? I don't think so.
I was only hanging out with Becky to help with Stewie. But she clearly saw it as something else. I gotta break it off before Lois finds out.
You need to break it off, cause it's the right thing to do.
When did you get glasses?
You like them? They're Kirby Parkers.
Well, Chris and Meg are off to school. Guess it's just you and me now. You want a popsicle? Huh? Breakfast popsicle? Whoa, there's vodka in here. Now what did you want? All right, let's go play in the hot yard.
I'm 2.5 hours late for preschool.
Your dad? Wait, who wants milk? Let me quick just check in the freezer. You burger. Here's your veggie burger. It'll thaw out. You suck on it. It'll thaw out nice. All right, I'm out of here. This is the perfect amount of drunk for a fillet of fish.
Cup.
Yeah, cup. Wow.
All right, time to go, everybody.
What? Where are we going?
My cousin's getting married this weekend. Brian, I need your help with Stewie on the flight.
Sure, no problem.
The iPad's broken.
Brian Face!
Mm-hmm.
Brian Face!
Yep.
Brian Face!
Only a few more now.
Da-da-da-da-da.
Okay, all right. Gotta be getting tired soon.
You see, when young kids act out, what they're really doing is asking to be heard. They have very little control in their lives, so the key, and I mean key, is to make them an active participant in these decisions. And once you do that, you'll see a big difference. Hi, can I get some of those tiny square napkins? Yeah, like the most you're allowed to give.
There they are, the boys. Come on in, fellas.
Dang, Stewie. This is a legit little pad you got here.
Yeah, that one spot creaks a little. I might have him look at it.
Oh, I didn't even notice.
So yeah, you know, pretty self-explanatory. Couch, plasma, kind of a little office nook over there, and...
Heyo! Boom! Photo booth with props, if anyone's feeling sassy. Eh? Eh?
Yes. But, do you mind if we take a rain check? I gotta take Chris to baseball in, like, 5 minutes.
Well, come by later. Maybe we can watch a movie or something.
Wow, that's super generous of you, Stewie. This place is dope.
Stewie, I'm telling you, there's no way Chris is gay.
Oh, why? Because he never hit on you? God, the ego.
Hey, Chris, what's up?
Just relaxing, listening to some of Charles Manson's music. What's up with you guys?
Actually, Brian and I are taking a survey, and we wanted to see if you had a few minutes.
Sure, go ahead.
Okay, question one. What night are the Tony Awards?
Tony Danza has awards?
Name an appropriate price to pay for jeans.
$5?
What year did Bette Midler release You've Got to Have Friends?
Oh, 1972. And it was fabulous!
Chris, are you gay?
What? No, I'm not gay.
Well, then why didn't you go out with that girl?
Why would I? I have everything I need in that department on my computer.
You have 28 windows of porn playing simultaneously?
Sometimes I pretend I'm at the security desk at the mall, and everyone at the mall is banging each other.
Chris, don't you see? You're so desensitized by all this porn, you're not even interested in actual girls.
What are you doing?
I'm taking this, and we are going to help you start thinking about sex like a normal teenager.
All right, I'll give it a shot. But it's not going to be easy. I had a hell of a time getting off sugar.
Chris, can you pass the syrup?
Oh, you want the syrup, old man? Yeah!
Yeah, nice attached head, Meg. Body, throw potatoes. Winner declared!
Hi, I'm almost ready.
Great. How you doing, champ?
Okay, Cliff and I should be back by midnight. I left money for you two to order a pizza.
Sounds perfect. All right, Kyle, what do you say you and me watch some Stranger Things?
Brian made Kyle bread and butter and kept the pizza money.
Ich bin...
I'm glad we're finally getting some practice in.
Yeah, nothing like running around after eating a seafood tower.
What are you doing here? You're supposed to be at the baseline.
Yeah, baseline, right.
He's serving to you. Get back there. You've never played tennis, have you?
Not once.
Damn it, Brian. I entered us in that tournament because you said you could play. And I will not be humiliated in front of shallow, rich alcoholics.
I'm Sarah McLachlan, and for just $1 a day, you can help save one of these abused and terrified grips from the Ellen DeGeneres Show. Whether it's a Teamster sobbing in his car after work, or a camera operator having a sandwich slapped out of his hand just for making eye contact, they need your help. So please, give today. Because no one should have to spend Thanksgiving watching a millionaire try on sweaters.
Kids, you really gotta clean the dog poop off your shoes right when it happens. It's so much harder to get it off once it's dried.
You're more than welcome to return to the workforce.
A sexy show for teens.